Welcome children to the new video in which you will learn about active and passive voice. It is a very important topic in grammar, English grammar, and you will come to know what is active voice, what is passive voice, and how to create sentences in active and passive voice. First of all, children, verb is an essential part of a sentence. Without a verb, no sentence can be created in English language. That is for certain. It's sure. Now, action. Any action in the world is either done by someone or received by someone. When you show it in a sentence, then the action word, that is the verb, V-E-R-B, verb, is either presented to be done by the subject or it is presented to be received by the subject. Both the cases are quite different from each other and both the cases are quite unique in themselves. The case in which the action is done by the subject, the verb is said to be active, and so the sentence is said to be in active voice. The case in which the action is received by the subject in the sentence, the sentence is said to be in passive voice. Now, in sentences in active voice, how will you identify? These sentences are written quite shorter. When you look at these sentences, they are quite short. They are precise. They are more elegant. They have a beauty of their own. And the performer of action not known, if the performer of the action is not known, in that case also you can use an active sentence. For example, my pocket was picked. In this case, I don't know who picked my pocket. I don't know the person. I cannot even identify. So, but I can tell it directly, my pocket was picked. Another important thing is when the action is more important than the performer. For example, if we are talking about the flights which were cancelled, this is more important. So the sentence can be created as, or all morning flights were cancelled. Or all international flights have been cancelled by India. It was yesterday in the news. Another example. If we want to put emphasis on the person that receives the action, then also in that case you can use the active voice. For example, if it is not important who did this action, but who received. For example, two agreements were signed. It is not important who signed, but the agreements were signed, this action is important. In that case, active voice can be used. So Radhika makes puppets. What is more important is Radhika makes puppets. Radhika, the performer, is important. Action is important. Sentences in passive voice. Action is more important than who performed it. So, another thing is, emphasis is on the person or thing that receives the action. The person who is receiving is more important. For example, the ball was passed to Mohan. Who passed the ball? Not important to be known. The ball was passed to whom? To Mohan. This is important. Emphasis is on the person or thing that receives the action. For example, puppets are made by Radhika. Puppets are made by whom? By Radhika. One thing to be noted here is the tense of the active sentence. That is, the active sentence in whatever tense it has been written should not change when the active sentence is changed into passive voice. When the sentence in active voice is changed into passive voice, only the voice will change, but not the tense will change. The tense will remain the same in both the cases, in both the voices. Thank you. Revise well.